Like drug addiction, porn addiction is the excessive use of pornography, and it affects everyday relationships, it affects all aspects of our lives, and many Canadians are caught in the grip of pornography. Now, according to various reports, the porn industry is worth about $97 billion a year. And from the National Center on Sexual Exploitation, their research is showing that pornography is growing, especially amongst young people. 64% of those aged 13 to 24 are actively seeking out pornography on a weekly basis, and sometimes even more often. And to talk about pornography and the addiction is Matt Cline. Matt, welcome to 100 Huntley Street.
Thanks, Greg. Great to be here.
So you start to play hockey, and you find out at a pretty early age you're good at it. You make it to Major Junior, the Red Deer Rebels, and also Chilliwack Bruins, British Columbia. Things were going good, but then you suffered a concussion, and those dreams started to get put to the side.
Things were going well. I was one of the top players on my team, and the NHL draft was maybe going to happen. And at the start of 1 year, when I was 18 years old, I got a concussion. And I didn't know it at the time, but it ended up being the last game that I ever played when I got hit.
How did you react to that? I mean, this is the death of a dream.
It was absolutely the death of a dream. At that point, it was really all that I knew. And how did I react to it? It was hard watching my team play and not knowing when my headaches were gonna go away, even just from a physical standpoint and feeling good, but also just wanting to be out on the ice. And as that year went on, it just progressed to the point where I realized I might not be able to play again. But what was neat was about a week after I got hurt, our team chaplain gave a message, and it really impacted me and really deepened my relationship with the Lord. And so I felt his peace that whole year.
So what were you thinking then? The hockey thing is done. What's next?
No idea. I had no idea what I was going to do, what I was good at. All my association, my friends were in hockey. It's all I had ever known or worked on. And so I just prayed, and I just had to talk to my parents about what could I do and hear from the Lord about what was next in my life.
But during this time, again, growing up in a Christian home, you were dealing with what a lot of young boys deal with, a lot of men deal with, and girls as well, and women, is pornography.
Yeah, and I was, I think, even a preteen when my friend showed it to me for the first time. And from then on, it was a part of my life. And like you say, it is for a lot of people. When I was about 21 years old, I was able to stop watching. And the reason why I wanted to at that point was because I wanted to be free of pornography by the time I got married. And I thought, well, if that's going to happen, there's got to be a last time. And so I stopped for a couple of years. And in that time, though, it was more my strength that I relied on, and I had made a good decision, and I didn't understand how to have Jesus and the love that he has for me as the foundation for my being free from pornography.
But you were feeling guilt, I'm sure, at this time, because you knew this was wrong, but like any addiction, you go back to it, but then you get to this point where you say, I've had enough, and for a while that works.
For a while it works, and then temptation comes, and you know, Satan says he'll leave you alone for a while until an opportune time, and he'll strike again. And I didn't know how to be guarded to deal with that. And so all the shame that I had and the guilt that I had when I fell back a second time, it seemed to me more than it was the first time. And I didn't know how to deal with it.
So how did you deal with it? How did you break free?
I broke free through a lot of praying and saying, God, I need something to be strong enough, so strong that I can finally break free from this. And in a church service one time, I felt the Lord came to me and he said to me, you know, Matt, I can't use you until you're pure. That was what I needed to hold on to.
Not perfect, right? Not because nobody's perfect. So when you say pure, what do you think you felt the Lord was saying to you at that point?
You know, I think it was maybe even a personal call for me because I wanted to be used, but the Lord wanted me to, you know, work in this area of healing with pornography and helping other people get free. And so if I'm going to do that, I had to get free myself. So it's like you say, we don't have to be 100% free from all sin in order to be used, but for me, I had to in this area, and that was the start of a journey for me, understanding how the intimacy with the Lord and the love that Jesus has for me can be my foundation to stay free forever.
And to do that, Matt, you have to make sure that you maintain that relationship. Okay, I got this now, that's pretty dangerous to do. So what are some of the practical things you do to make sure that you don't fall back into pornography?
Yeah, you know, I mean, a lot of people talk about get internet filters and get accountability, and those are really good things, but that's really getting your foot in the game. That's the starting point. And from there, you want to know what it is to have the Lord be your foundation. And so when I go to scripture and I see that he says to be thankful in all circumstances or to rejoice always, well, then when I get maybe rejected or there's disappointments in life, I don't need to go back to pornography for my comfort, because I can know how to be thankful and to rejoice and do the things that the Lord wants me to do.
Yeah, that's the thing. I mean, when pressure comes, those things that we've struggled with or been addicted to, whether it's drugs, alcohol, pornography, whatever it is, those are the things that we tend to jump back to, unfortunately. But for you now, you not only got yourself free, you're married, you're a dad now, but you're working with others to help them break free. Tell me about what you're doing now in the whole area of helping people break free of pornography.
You know, when Jesus died and rose again, it says that we died and we rose with him, and he broke the power of sin on our life. And so when I struggle with the sin, I see it as I'm not fully understanding what Jesus died for and who he made me to be. And the more I can understand who Jesus sees me as being, the more I can live free. And I want to help equip other people to live that same way and understand, how does Jesus see me? How does Jesus see you? How can I live in that way?
Yeah, and it's such a key point. Now, we're going to put your web address on the screen here, because you have resources not only for those that are battling pornography, but also people that are in the lives of those that are struggling with pornography. The name of your ministry and also the website is restoredministry.ca. So what are some of the things, Matt, that you're doing to help people break the grip of pornography?
Yeah, so we do some in-person coaching and also online coaching. There's a boot camp online that people can take all over the world.
What's a boot camp look like?
Good question. The boot camp is there's 8 films and then 8 worksheets, one to go along with each film. And there's different topics. Battling through withdrawal would be one topic, your identity in Christ and how that relates. So there's 8 topics that people can work through. And there's people all over the world taking it. So that's something that people can do if they're really struggling with pornography. And then if someone's not struggling with porn, but they're passionate about this and they want to make a difference, there's resources on the site for them to know how to talk to people who are struggling, how to talk to their pastor about starting programs. And we also do live events as well.
How important is it, as we're having this conversation right now, talking about pornography? Because 10 or 20 years ago, you know, I was like, you don't talk about it. And people like yourself, perhaps, living, you know, in this sort of dark place where you feel the shame. Is this conversation important?
Yeah, pornography is something that you indulge in by yourself in the dark. And so what grows in isolation, it has to be broken in community. And so it's super important to bring what's in the dark out into the light and talk to people. And you realize when you do that, that when you feel shame, but you talk to someone, what you get back most of the time is a lot of love from that person. It starts to break the power of shame.
Well, you know, as I talked about at the beginning of the program, 64% of those ages 13 to 24 are looking at pornography. I mean, the problem, Matt, is it is so accessible.
It's so accessible more than ever. And, you know, the porn producers are smarter than they ever have been, too, with how the internet works. And they can put keywords or little tags on their videos. And so when a little kid then searches something like gummy bears, that can be something that a porn producer knows, and he puts that attached to his video, and it'll pop up when these kids search Google.
You know, it's so important, Matt, what you're doing, and, you know, keep going strong. I know that it's difficult. You've probably had times where people have had success and other times not so much so.
Yeah, absolutely. And you just want everybody to be free from pornography so badly. And some people do get free, and other ones it takes a little bit longer.
You know, and wherever you're at today, maybe you've broken free of pornography, you've fallen back into it, or you're into it now, or you're a family member or a friend of somebody that's dealing with pornography. Matt's got a great website, great resources. Again, it's restoredministries.ca. Get a hold of Matt and his team, and they'll help you out. And we also have prayer people standing by, somebody just to talk to, somebody to pray with. One of the things that happens when we talk about these things, we bring light to these situations, and we can get free. There is hope. Matt is a testimony of that. Many others have broken the addiction of pornography. Our number is 1-866-273-4444, or you can email us at prayer@crossroads.ca. Maybe you don't want to say, like, I'm dealing with pornography, but you want to send an email. Feel free to do that and get freedom today.